Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. From this video, we will start learning the Espresso framework that is for UI testing. So from this video, we will start doing the UI testing of our project. And to make everything quicker, I have completed the whole project already because this course is about testing and not about building the application. So you can get the source code from the link that is given in the description of this video and you can check the project. Now in this video, we will learn testing a fragment in isolation. So here I have two fragments in my application. One is to add a spend to the database. As you can see here, I have my fragment add spend open and this is a very simple test sign. And we are going to test this fragment in this video. So the logic is we will enter the amount and the description for the spend and we will click on this button. If the spend is added successfully to the database, we will get this success message. And this is what we are going to test in this video. And for UI testing, we will be using the Espresso testing framework. Using Espresso, we can simulate the user interaction in our application. So basically we will code the things and it will be like a real user is using our application. So let's see how we can do this thing. So first we will come inside our fragment class. In my case, it is @spendFragment. And now for this class, I will generate a test class. The process is same to generate a test class. Just right click, go to generate and select test and then hit OK. Now again, as this is a UI test, we need to create the test class inside the Android test package because we are going to test the fragment. So we will hit OK and this is our class. Now one more thing I would like to tell you that someone asked this in the comments, like why I am inheriting this class, that is test case, to all my test classes. So here I will define run with as well. And this time also it is Android JUnit 4 class. I will remove this assert because we are using the truth library for assertions. And the question here is why I am inheriting this test case class. So if I go to an older test class, let's say spend view model test, then this function that is public override fun setup is inside this test case class, but this is optional because it is the JUnit 3 way. So what I will do is for all the next videos, I will not use this test case because I don't know why I use this because it is an older way. And this function that is set up is inside this test case class, but now it is optional and you may not use it if you want. So we will delete it because it is not required now. Now, once we delete it, you can see we are getting the error that is override fun setup because this function was inside the test case class. So what we can do is we can simply remove the override keyword like this and everything else is fine. We also need to remove this super.setup because we don't have any parent class now. And that's it, that's enough. This before function will be called before the test function. So that's it, we do not need to inherit or extend the test case class now. Now let's go back to our @spendFragment test. Inside this class, we will test our @spendFragment. And to test a fragment, first we need the fragment. And to create a fragment inside the test class, we can use a scenario, that is a fragment scenario. It is a class. Let's see how we can use this thing. So what I will do is I will define a private late init var and we can simply name it scenario and you can name it whatever you want. And it is a fragment scenario. Now we will define the scenario type as the fragment that we want to test. In this case, I want to test @spendFragment. So this is my fragment that I want to test. Now we need to launch the fragment. So again, I will define a before function and it is the setup function. And inside this function, I will launch the fragment. So we will initialize the scenario. So here we will write scenario equals to launch fragment in container. Now to this function, that is launch fragment in container, we also need to define the theme for our fragment. It is very important. So here I will define theme res id equals to r dot style dot theme. We need to import the r, and then we have theme span tracker, that is my application's theme. So we have the scenario. Now we will use one more function to move the fragment to a specific state. So here I will write scenario dot move to state. So to define the state, we will write here lifecycle dot state dot, we will use the started state. So here are other states to test your fragment. For example, we have created, destroyed, initialized, and resumed. For this example, I'm going to use started state. Now our fragment is set up. Now we just need to write the test function. Now for this fragment, I will create only one function because I just want to check the logic, that is adding a span. So here I will create a test function. So we have a fun test adding span, or you can name your function whatever you want. Now inside this function, first we will simulate the user input. So to add a span, we need to add amount and description. And to enter the amount and description, first we need the edit text where we need to input the values. So let's see how we can do this thing using Espresso. So what we need is, we need the view, that is our edit text. And to do this, we have a function that is called onView, like this. We will import the onView function. Now to the onView function, we will use a matcher function, that is a view matcher. So there are many options. For this example, we will match the view using ID. So here I will write with ID function, like this. Now we also need to import this function. Now here I will pass the ID of amount. First I'll enter the amount. So for this case, I will enter the ID of the amount, and I don't remember the ID. So I'll go to the fragment and I will check the view IDs. So first we need to enter the amount, and for this we have edit text amount. So here I will write r dot id dot the ID. Now we will call the function perform to perform an action on this view. Now the action that I will perform here is type text, like this. We also need to import this function. And here we will type a text to this edit text amount. Now I will also define the values. First I have amount equals to, let's say, 100, and I have description, let's say pot x or whatever. Now here I will pass amount dot to string, because we can only type string inside an edit text. Now the same way I will perform a type text operation on this description. So this time I will get the description, that is edit text description. So here I will call onView with ID, the description ID, then perform type text and description, and it is already a string, so I do not need to use the toString function. Now I have entered the amount and the description. Now after entering the amount and the description, we need to press this button. But when we are entering the amount and the description, keyboard is showing in this area, and that is why this button is not visible. And to fix this thing, we need to call a function, that is espresso.closeSoftKeyboard, and this function will close the keyboard. Now we can perform the click operation on our button. So again we will do the same thing, that is onView with ID, and I will get the button ID from here, it is button add. So I will write here r.id.buttonAdd, then perform, and this time we will perform the click operation. That's it. Now finally, we will assert that after clicking the button, we are getting the success message in our text view. And to do this, again we will use the assert that function, and inside the function we will write the condition, that is on view, and we have the with ID, then we have the text view ID where we are displaying the success message, and then we are checking if it matches with our success message. And this is a blank string. I will replace it with the success message, and this is my success message here, like this. So our test function is ready. Now we can simply test whether it is working or not. And to test the function, we have the same method. We will just click this play button here and it will run the test. And make sure your device is running, because this is a UI test and it requires a real device. And here I have my device and you can see the test running here. So the tests are running and this is my device, and here the fragment will be launched, as you can see here. And we are entering the values, then we click the button and we got the text that is spend added, and that is why our test passed. So it is working absolutely fine. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. In case you need my source code, then you can get it from the link that is given in the description of this video. And if you found this video helpful, then please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel if you're not already a subscriber, and you can share this video with all your friends who are learning Android application development. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.